to lose it. Death is perfectly designed. It doesn't make any judgment of the universe, of quantum mechanics, of particle physics, but it's like, you gotta let go of all that. It's easy. What's the big problem? There's nothing I can rationalize or think about myself that would say, I will survive. I will survive! Nothing, because it's like, it hasn't been bad, but the biggest thing that hit you, like what hit me, is how hard it's been. It's all been very hard, even if it's been good. That's all I can share. And then I had this profound thought, like, why think about what it doesn't matter to think about? I also feel I won't miss anything, because I'm not missing anything right now. And this is my life. When my life ends, I won't have my life. I won't be missing anything. That's a big thing that haunts certain people. I hate the idea of not being around. That converts into the mathematical, cosmological equation. You'll be missing something, but you won't.
That's, yeah, I think that's where the idea of spirits and ghosts come in, they're missing something.
And the other thing that I've always been convinced of is, when you're dead, you're out of space and time. So really, the Last Judgment makes sense, because once out of space and time, everything happens at once. That's what Einstein said about the utility of time. A woman asked him, Mr. Einstein, why do we have to have time? And he said, what do you want everything to happen at once?
Where it was.
No wonder there's these concepts, because when you're dead, really, everybody else is dead almost instantaneously, because you're no longer in time.
Well, what about the approach to death?
Thank you. Move back, there we go. Tracks coming down, tracks are now on.
Tracks are coming down.